Hey everyone, welcome back. This is our weekly WeAwake group meditation. So glad you're here. So today we're gonna do PMP, Profound Meditation Program, Level 3, Track 2. And Profound Meditation, or PMP as we call it for short, 3.0 is one of our flagship things. We've been using it from the very beginning of WeAwake. It's going on 11 years now, I think. And I always come back to these tracks, no matter how far afield I go, they're really powerful. And this third level is dealing with very deep, powerful delta. And the third level is just really strong stuff. This is, you can do it at home, but just, you know, it's pretty strong, which is good, right? Because we need strong tools to, keep us in the zone where we need to be to do what we need to do and experience what we need to experience. So so without further ado, why don't we get into this? And it's only 20 minutes, so do whatever a meditation practice that you know that you have been called to do, or you can just focus on your heart and slow your breathing down and relax. And a nice thing to get started is just do a kind of count backwards. You can do it from five and just see the number five in your mind and say relax, four, relax, and just feel your shoulders and everything relaxing. And it gets you in a good place where your body can be open and receptive, and you can release stress and you can get more out of your meditation. And God help us to get what we need today. And you know, one of my prayers is when I meditate, is there anything I need to be learning? Anything I need to be letting go of? Anybody I need to be forgiving? Anything I need to, in any category I might have forgotten? Please let me know as I'm here. And most of all, I just want to experience your presence, because that's what I need to keep myself going and do the right thing. So let's get going, and we'll check in on the other side.
Thank you.
Welcome here. Yeah, that was a PMP32. It's a very powerful track. Good stuff. And we are living in very dramatic times. What is that? The old Chinese curse. May you live in interesting times. Well, we certainly are doing that. Things are changing so rapidly. And huge war in Europe going on now that, you know, the invading side seems to be getting its butt kicked, and they have nuclear weapons. So, wow. So what can we do? Well, that's a great question. I'm pretty personally involved in the Ukrainian war. I have friends over there, and I've been kept posted on it, and they don't know that someday they're going to do the numbers, but at least 50,000 civilians have been killed. That's probably a low estimate, and millions of refugees, the Russians are admitting to over 20,000 of their soldiers having been killed. They're admitting to it. So God knows what the true numbers are. So it's just a bloodbath over there. And it's absolutely senseless. Yeah. Because one man has a vision of glory that wants to make an empire. He's already the dictatorial leader of the largest country, geographically speaking, on the planet. So what can we do? Well, we can definitely support. We have an iAwake funnel to get funds. Please check it out at our website to get funds to our friends and colleagues who are on the front lines and working with the refugees and sending medical supplies and food and other things and training in first aid to there in Lithuania, right on the border. And we have pictures, and they're sending in drivers into Ukraine to help the people out that are still there and still suffering and still fighting. And and it seems in the last few years, and just worldwide, including the United States, we've had this move toward authoritarian dictatorships, and democracy, which we kind of taken for granted, has really taken some hits. Yeah, but we almost lost it here with the last administration, January 6th, and et cetera. It was really close. So what can we do? Well, one of the things we can do individually is work on ourselves and develop ourselves so that we can become the type of people who can deal with democratic institutions and governments. And it takes a pretty high level of development to get there, at least a modern level of development. Before that, everybody wants popes and dictators and blah, blah. So we have to get, and definitely have the United States, the foundations of the country were very humanistic and modern, and all people are created equal. Right, with inalienable rights to liberty, peace, and the pursuit of happiness. And it was the first democracy, per se. I mean, there were some examples of Athens in 5th century BC, which were democratic if you weren't a slave, if you weren't a woman, and you owned property. So, right, how democratic is that? But anyway, they had some beginnings of that kind of governance, spiced with dictators and back and forth, and Rome started out like that. Of course, it ended in dictatorship, but we've been hanging in here for a couple hundred years, the United States, and the idea of democracy has spread all over the world. And as far as I can see, it's the best thing going that we have right now. And there's really no examples historically of democracies attacking democracies. So maybe peace in Europe, you know, would be for Russia to actually become a democracy. And there's this anyway. So Another thing that we've been doing here as part of the team is we've been doing that podcast called Deep Transformation. I hope you guys will check out on your Apple podcast app or Spotify or wherever you get your podcasts. And again, the idea of transformation of the individual and the idea that I got from the writings of the meta political ideas of Hansi Freinacht, and of course the integral ideas that I've been working with forever, that interior development has to be a part of the human plan. I think our welfare programs in the United States have been grossly ineffective because they just focus on one thing, just giving people food stamps and cash when or money when they need it, which is probably, yeah, you don't want people to starve, but it ain't enough. Because not only do we have to feed our bodies, right? We have to feed our minds and our hearts and our spirits. And the Germans have a word for that called Bildung, which kind of, it's like, I don't know the translation, but the building of the self. And when I was in college, I read the German romantics and they had Bildung romans, which are development, evolutionary novels, where it takes the history of the story of the young hero, and you see him go through all these adventures and misadventures until he kind of wakes up and becomes a man. And that needs to be all our stories, that we wake up and become truly who we need to be. And it's really, really important. You know, if we enough of us get to the point where we can truly be world-centric and democratic and compassionate and connected to the greater vision, evolutionary vision of the planet and our species and who we are and how we fit into it and the possibilities of the future, the good possibilities and the really bad possibilities if we don't do the work necessary. And it starts at home, right? It starts with you, it starts with me doing that work. So you never know what your calling is going to be or what part you're going to affect. But again, as I often say, that if you're going to be part of the solution, not part of the problem, which is a quote from John Lennon, you're going to have to work on yourself. We have to work on ourselves. We're going to have to reach those places of peace inside in the midst of the storm, that where we can direct ourselves from our heart center and from our wisdom center. And sometimes that love has to be ruthless and strong and has to even fight, as in the case of Ukraine right now, for their existence as a nation, for existence as a people, for their old people, for their young people, for their land, for their culture, for their dignity, for their freedom. So work hard. You can tell it works. We have a young friend who's staying with Pam, and we meditate every morning now for a minimum of an hour, and it really, really helps. And that's been remarkable to watch a young person doing this practice. So it's good to have a meditation partner if you don't have one, or get meditation groups. And you could, of course, you can do it in the Zoom world too, if you can't get together with people, or maybe even get together once a week and meditate. And of course, I would definitely suggest using this technology because it'll get you there a lot faster and a lot more effective. And we need to get there faster and more effectively because we don't have apparently a lot of time. Things are really speeding up. So so I'm feeling some peace, but I'm also feeling some heaviness and sorrow. And I'll be going to Europe soon to go to Hungary for a conference over there, integral conference. And I'll be meeting with some of my Ukrainian colleagues and friends who have been on the front lines, who've been working their hearts out. And that was one of the reasons I decided to go, is to be with them and support them. And I haven't been on my airplane in like a long time, but I'm going to do that. And hopefully it will be, good will come out of it. And when good people get together for good reasons and try to do the right thing, generally good things come of it. So let's hope that's so in this case. After that, I'll be in London visiting some of our iAwake and friends and colleagues over there. So you're going to be able, and if you live in London, drop me an email. Maybe we can get together and talk. So anyway, keep practicing every day, every day, every day. All right. Best time is to do it in the morning and just get your practice down. So you get out of bed and, you know, you do the zombie walk to your meditation place or put on your tea or coffee, whatever, and boom, you just do it because it's what you do. And I have a dog and she really likes consistency. You know, she just expects me to be there for her at the right time and feed her and walk her and do what I'm supposed to do. So she appreciates the security and the consistency. And even when we're traveling, we're on the road, there's still a consistency we built into the care of our good friend Tatum. So if it's good for your dog, it's good for you. So take care of yourself. Anyway, I have rambled enough. So God bless you guys. It's good to see everybody. And yeah, keep praying, keep meditating, keep exercising, keep eating right, keep reading and absorbing wisdom and the right stuff, and work hard. And my young friend that's staying with us here has been in the United States for a long time, a few years. And he says, one thing I've learned about the United States is that you've really got to work hard. And I said, well, that's a really good lesson to learn. It's true. If you work hard, you get things done, both in building an economy, building a democracy, and building a spiritual life. So work hard, everybody. And the harder you work, it's easier. And it gets to be more fun. And you start looking forward to doing your practice instead of, oh, no, I got to go to do that again. Now it's like, yeah, I get to do that again. And you feel grateful and it inspires and strengthens you. So that's it. I'll stop. Okay. Love you guys. Bye. Thank you.